they have a store of plutonium elsewhere. We yet don't know how much. We don't know how many have been turned into
And they
weapons.
Won't let us see it.
That's going to be the part of the next negotiation, okay. Which is what the inspectors get to see. Do the inspectors get to see the actual weapons? Wasn't said today.
Right. That's, they have basically said, they did say, I mean, it's clear the North Koreans said, look, we can come in here and look at certain things, but we're not going to have some inspection all over our country.
That's right. And so that's why it's important to get to this next phase where we discuss fuel they've already produced, weapons they've already produced, and this secret uranium program that they may appear to have purchased from AQCon, but we don't know if it ever went anyplace. You know, the Khan also supplied the same package to the Iranians. It took the Iranians a long time. It's been more than 20 years before they got to the point where they actually could figure out how to produce uranium.
Well, how come the North Koreans could do it faster than the Iranians?
Well, the North Koreans tried a different process to the bomb, which was plutonium out of the reactor. But yes, they do have the knowledge. And remember, North Korea conducted a nuclear test in 2006. The tone you heard from the president today was interesting on this. A few years ago, he would step out in the Rose Garden, usually with the South Korean president at his side, and say, we will never tolerate a nuclear North Korea. He wouldn't say what he'd do if there was a nuclear North Korea, a nuclear weapons state North Korea. Well, since 2006, when they conducted their test, it's clear they at least know how to do a crude nuclear explosion. They may not know how to make a sophisticated weapon. That's the issue now. The issue now is, with the amount of knowledge and the amount of material they still have, is it possible to get them to give up everything?
And what will you pay for it? Okay, transfer this to Iran. So where are we there? Because I see an increasing number of people, it seems to me, are saying, there's nothing we can do. They're going to get the nuclear weapons. That's on one channel of sort of consideration. Mm-hmm. The other channel is, look at what the Israelis are doing. They pretty much at least wanted to raise the specter of, we're doing these little war games, and if you don't just watch us, then you'll be sorry.
That's right. We talk about Iran and North Korea as opposite parts of the same sentence. They're very different problems. North Korea is one of the poorest countries on Earth. That gives us some leverage. Food, oil, long winters, starving people.
And the Iranians. And the survival of the regime.
And the survival of the regime.
Join us online at charlierose.com.